to me, hi boys, give me a wave. Oh, you look fantastic in blue. You're like a bunch of Smurfs, you know? Look fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, I used to be an old boy for the Sydney Convicts. I used to play prop from the sideline. But I always turned up to the parties and drinking, right on? That's right. I'd like to welcome to the stage a lovely, very knowledgeable man. He is also the founder of the Sydney Convicts, and he's also the president for the Bingham Cup 2014. Please welcome to the stage, Fuzz!
Coco, thank you.
You're welcome.
To be here.
It's a pleasure to have you. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Fuzz, so can you just tell me just a few things before before the boys come on stage? Where are the boys today?
Well, the boys are all out the back here. Big crowd, big cheer for the Sydney Convicts. An enormous cheer out for our Waratah mates who have come down to support us as well. Thanks very much, guys. We're really lucky to have some great support from the Waratahs and the Wallabies. Yeah, and the Convicts are the envy of all the gay rugby teams around the world for the amount of support we've got.
Absolutely. So before we carry on and we talk about more about Bingham Cup. Hey, honey. How are you?
So I don't know whether you guys have seen Rugga Bugga, but the Sydney Convicts do Rugga Bugga at least once a year, and you know how much they hate getting their gear off.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Oh. They hate it. They so hate it. Oh, God. I love Rugga Bugga. And when is our next Rugga Bugga anyway?
Rugga Bugga will come up in April, so stay tuned. It's going to be bigger and better and more raunchy than you've ever seen before. Absolutely. So come down to the Midnight Shift for Rugga Bugga, Rugga Bugga 1 and 2 this year, in the lead-up to the Bingham Cup in August.
Absolutely. It's going to be an amazing turnout. So make sure you're there in April. So we're going to do strip trivia. We have Team A and we have Team B. Hello, boys. How are you?
They look very nervous.
No, they won't be once we're finished, Fuzz. Right, we're going to go straight into the game. So how it works is that we're going to ask you a question. You either yell out true or false. Now, from that, whoever wins that question, whoever loses that question, we will ask someone from the crowd which one of you three will take a piece of clothing off. So in other words, you've only got two pieces each. Fantastic.
And we don't count hats. Hats are not counted.
No hats, no socks.
So the team completely naked first loses.
Here we go. Question number one. Elvis Presley came third on an Elvis lookalike contest.
True or false? You got 2 seconds to work out whether it's true or false.
What's the answer?
We'll say true.
Right, you guys lost.
Okay,
ladies and gentlemen, is it number one, two, or three that you want to take something off?
Three, I think it's number three.
Right, it sounds like number three.
Christian, shirt off.
Oh my gosh, let's have a look. Oh, they don't build them in Samoa like that, that's for sure. But that's beautiful, I must say. Right, moving right along. Next question we have. Slugs don't have any noses. True or false? Slugs don't have any noses.
Slugs false. Don't have any noses. True or false?
No, you said true, so it's false. So, is it number one or two? Or three is going to take something off? Two.
Looks like
number two.
Two.
There you go, Mr. Kevin. Just to let you know, everyone, he's our little Canadian stallion.
We have a Palm, a Canadian, and an Aussie on this team.
Well, you know, I did marry a Canadian. I hope he's out there somewhere.
And a Canadian, Brazilian, and an Aussie.
Perfect.
And we've got two prop forward drag queens. Who would have thought?
Absolutely, here I am. Okay, moving along to our next question. England won at the Rugby World Cup in 2004. That's so true, right?
True or false?
It wasn't won in 2004, it's false.
Get you with your accent.
False. You guys lost. One person takes some clothing
off.
Sorry,
they got the answer. Okay, I think it's number one.
Number one.
We choose shorts. Right, we're getting close to the end of the game. Okay, in space, it's impossible to cry. True or false?
You guys. True?
Sorry, guys. Take something else. Ladies and gentlemen, is it number one? Is it number two? Is it number three?
Number two.
Number two it is. God, that's amazing. Right, moving along. Quade Cooper was born in Australia. True or false? Take someone off. Take something off, I mean. Number one or three?
Number one.
Here we go.
Bill, get it off. Now, Bill is an expert push-up artist. He's done 600,000 push-ups in a 24-hour period. Be careful what you ask for.
Well, exactly. I'm actually dripping quietly from here. Thank you so much, number one. Oh, and you've got hair. Oh, he's a bear, everybody. He's a bear. Okay. Silly mid.
Silly mid on is a fielding position in cricket. True or false?
Oh,
true.
Sorry, boys. Number three. Here you go.
Okay, now we're getting the interesting part of the game.
So it's the first team with everything off besides what... Okay. Okay, next question.
Most Eskimos have a refrigerator. True or false?
True.
Okay, who's got their pants on?
Okay, is it number one, two, or three? Two. Okay, do a bit of a shake. We can play swords later. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the letter T is the second most common letter used in the English language. True or false? Hi, ladies. One, two, or three, ladies and gentlemen? Two.
Two.
Oh my gosh, Anaconda, baby! Have you guys met Anaconda? Mm-hmm. Right. Here's a question for you, my sir.
Okay, question. The number two is a prime number. True or false?
Sorry.
It's true.
It's true. Number one or three, ladies and gentlemen?
Okay, three.
Three
get your gear off. Christian, get your gear off. Okay, lucky they're pretty. They don't know the number two
it's
is a prime number.
It's 2-1, coming to the end, very end.
Okay, an ostrich's eyes is bigger than its brain. True or false? The answer is true.
You were first. They said it first. Don't you argue with the drag queen.
Yeah.
Don't you argue with her. Off.
Okay.
We got our losers. Can you please pose? And our winners, Team B. So ladies and gentlemen, if we want to see, they're going to take them off. We just want to say thank you to our lovely sponsor, teammate, while the boys just do a little parade for the ladies and gentlemen out there. So teammates, I'm sure there's stores out there somewhere. Please go purchase a pair. They're probably about $109 each anyway. Okay, so we're just going to carry on with our... This year we have 2014, we have the Sydney Convicts hosting the 2014
Bingham Cup.
Bingham Cup. Bingham Cup.